Hello again, everyone. I'm Tiegon. Let's play more Cataclysm Dark Days Ahead. Last time, Michael dies horribly. Jones died horribly. So apparently everything's going to plan. That gave me... Michael dies... The fact that my last character died gave me an opportunity to upgrade the version of my game. So I've upgraded to the latest version of the game. And I get to create a new character. And I'm going to create... Chuck Stone. Chuck Stone's a man who throws stones at anyone who gets in his way. Chuck Stone is not an ugly man, but he is a straight shooter who tells the truth whenever he hears it. He says it like he sees it. Chuck Stone is definitely a savant, although he wouldn't consider himself that. He just is a man who does what he likes all the time, and that's throwing stones. Because throwing stones is something that will save your life. It could have saved a lot of people. Chuck Stone's a man where if he gets a... He throws stones as quickly as possible. And if he gets a metallic stone-throwing device that some people call a gun, he will throw his stones as quickly as possible. Chuck Stone... Let's define what kind of man Chuck Stone is. We're looking at his negative traits first. Oh, and I should explain what happened to Michael Dies Horribly Jones. Well, last time, there's a new concept in the game, the stamina system, and throwing takes your stamina down, and I was not fully aware of this, and I was not paying attention to stamina. It's like I was aware of the stamina system, but I was not full aware of all the intricacies of the stamina system, and I threw nails until I got exhausted and then was overwhelmed by zombies. And it was a rookie mistake. That was a rookie throwing mistake. That's something that Chuck Stone would never do. Because Chuck Stone knows all about throwing the ins and outs. So being a savant means that I'm going to have half learning speed on all skills, but faster learning speed on one skill. And that will definitely, definitely be throwing. My game is going to be all about throwing. Okay, so what other negatives? I wanna max out my negatives, because that's what I like to do. Chuck Stone is a lightweight. He does not think drinking impairs your throwing capabilities, and so Chuck Stone does not often partake in alcohol. Chuck Stone is a heavy sleeper. Chuck Stone believes that sleep... Chuck Stone sleeps like a stone. To learn to throw a stone, you must be like a stone. In sleeping, you must become one with the stone. Alright, or something like that. I don't know. I'm trying to rationalize. Chuck Stone and animals do not get along. Because when Chuck Stone sees an animal, he sees a target for a stone. Or something. I don't know. Chuck Stone is a man with a strong scent. A strong, stony scent. It smells very, very rocky. Does Chuck Stone have good hearing? Do rocks hear very well? Chuck Stone does not tolerate lactose. I do not tolerate lactose. I do not... It does not have the stones to satisfy me, like... Alright, one last point. Should it be junk food again? Yeah, it's junk food again. Chuck Stone does not like junk food. Or should it be wheat? Huh, there is a lot of junk food out there, and junk food preserves very well. But wheat preserves pretty well, too. Or should I have a wool allergy? I like the idea of being able to wear wool. Should I be sleepy? No. Yeah, junk food. Junk food it is. Chuck Stone is not a man who tolerates junk food. I do not tolerate milk or junk food. I don't like it. But Chuck Stone is a man who is... Chuck Stone is a man who has... I'm tempted to pick robust genetics because it's just a fun... Having a robust genetics didn't pay off at all for my previous character, and yet I just like the idea. So I'm gonna put it in for now, and I might take it off if there's something else. Infatigable would be useful. high adrenaline could have saved my previous character, so I'm going to go with that. And they said that fast learning, if you combine it with Savant, does not actually make your learning speed faster overall. You'll have lower overall learning speed, but I will have faster learning on throwing skill, so I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. Should I take good memory? Chuck Stone is a man who remembers really well how to throw stones. I wonder how much the skill rust is going to be an issue on the one skill that I'm good at. I guess maybe I will, because I want to get the highest throwing skill I possibly can get, and so maybe that'll be an issue. Light step. Less noise and less likely to set off traps. Two reasons. I think I want to go with it. It's very tempting to take night vision. Yeah, I want night vision so much that I'm going to get rid of my robust genetics. Robust genetics will be for a different character. It sounds fun, but you got to go find either radiation or you got to eat a lot of irradiated fruit. All right, so I'm going to... Chuck Stone is a man who likes the way he is. He doesn't want to get genetically modified. Venom Mob Protege. I still don't know what that's about. I'll try that a different time. I don't think you can poison stones, so... Pack Mule. Pack Mule will be great, because that means I can gather more stones, and then I'll have more stones to throw. More space means more stones. Chuck Stone likes stones. Alright, so Chuck Stone was going to want a lot of strength, because I think strength makes you throw things further, and it lets you carry more weights, which means carrying more stones. Intelligence will be useful for the skill rust. Dexterity I definitely want high to at least... Well, throwing bonus. Throwing bonus. Does throwing bonus mean accuracy? Or... Question. Okay, well, I don't know if throwing bonus means accuracy or... I don't know exactly what throwing bonus means. I think it just means accuracy. If it's just accuracy, then I don't care as much. But if it's range as well, then I do care. The real thing is, you get more potential out of intelligence. Intelligence is going to lower my skill rust, lower my read times. It makes a character with more potential. The dexterity is more immediate ability. And perception's really useful for the long term because it'll help me see things at long range. I think I'm going to go with this setup. 14, 10, 10, 11. If the throwing bonus is range, then I made a mistake. But Chuck Stone is actually an intelligent person with good... Chuck Stone is just a generally talented person. But with no initial throwing skill. That is kind of awkward. But he's gonna learn. Hopefully Chuck Stone will learn. Chuck Stone's gonna live long enough to learn how to throw stones. Chuck Stone. Alright. And Chuck Stone is definitely going to live at a shelter. Does it have to be a normal shelter, not an Elmo shelter? Are you finished? Well, actually, an Elmo shelter could be kind of nice too, but no, normal shelter. I like the normal shelter life, because a normal shelter is nearby a town, usually. What is that? A refugee center. A refugee center. There was an episode of American Dad that made Chuck Stone laugh, called Camp Refugee. Because it was about a refugee camp. So the emergency jacket. It is winter at the start, and this jacket is quite warm. But it has no storage. Or no, two storage. A little bit of storage, just pockets. So, and I'm already wearing a winter coat. So, I'm gonna say no to the emergency jacket. Alright. The nice thing is there's a little computer console. Is there anything else? Emergency message. Do not panic. Remain inside. Seek shelter. Use provided gas masks. Await further instructions. Disable external power. Access denied. Contact us. If you have any feedback concerning your visit, please contact the Department of Emergency Management Public Affairs Office. The local office can be reached between the hours of 9 a.m. and 4 p.m. at 1-800... I'm not going to use that voice for the all the reading. 1-800-225-5678. If you would like to speak to us, speak with someone in person, or would like to write us a letter, please send it to... It takes forever for you to find an address on your map, but you mark the refugee center. Oh, it took forever for me to find that on the map, let me tell you. But I found it. Okay, well that seemed incredibly silly because it's right next to me. I can see it. I can see it from here. Nothing down here? Nothing down here. All right. I'm just going to put my blanket in the corner. Fold an emergency blanket. I unpack my emergency blankets and place them on the floor for future sleeping. And let's see what the world has in store for me. Ah, my first stone. Oh, what's this? A zombie grub. Once a soldier, dressed to the head and toe in combat gear, his hands constantly fumble at its many pouches. Don't tell me this zombie is going to throw a grenade at me. Well, actually, I would expect that it would. Yes, there was a zombie that... The zombie scientist threw a flask at me. Whoa, and a grim howler. This is not good. This is a very scary starting. Chuckstone is scared. What weapons does Chuckstone have? Chuckstone has a pocket knife. The grim howler is coming for Chuckstone. Chuckstone's gonna hide. Anything coming for Chuckstone? There's a crater over there with a fractal crescent. That's a crater. That reminds me very much of that other thing. The beads. The moving beads that I found. Oh, crap, it's the Grim Howler again. Okay, Grim Howler, you and me. We're gonna have to fight, aren't we? Wield that pocket knife. The pocket knife, 7 stab, minus 4 to hits. No, let's... I do not want to engage the Grim Howler. Maybe I can avoid it. Maybe I can avoid the... Not if the zombie grenadier is out there. Get back in. Whew. Ouchie! Okay. I was ripped up by the zombie grenadier decided to throw its grenade. Not a big surprise, but I'm surprised he decided to throw it. Oh, he probably threw it as soon as I saw him. Ouchie. There's a spring as well as many other items. Crap, and now there's a Grim Howler. Get inside! Oh, no, no, no. Oh, crap, oh, crap, oh, crap. I think I'm screwed. Oh my god. What do I do? It's time to panic. I think I'm gonna have to remake Chuckstone. This is pretty much bullshit. Wow. I wanna throw something, but I... Alright, you and me, Grim Howler, let's see if we can do this. Ouchie. Ouchie. Crap. Crap. Come on, can you get him? I'm not even hitting. I can't even hit. Perhaps I should stop wielding this pocket knife. Just throw the pocket knife at him and use your hands. I hit for 1 damage. Yeah, I'm actually hitting with my hands. Can I do this? Well, instead of being Chuck Stone, I'm now a martial artist. If I live this, I'm gonna be more of a savant of a martial... No, I'm screwed. My legs are dying. Fighting a wolf with your bare hands is pretty much foobar. Okay, am I getting the adrenaline boost yet? You'd think that the adrenaline would be going off about now. Come on, Chuck Stone. I don't even have stats anymore. No, thank you. Well, That was some... Well... No, let's actually talk about what killed me. Wolf! And... Grenadier, yes. I survived... What do you mean I survived 42 days? I didn't survive 42 days! Oh, maybe it's because of the age of the world or something? I don't know. Alright, well, that was fast. Alright, let's try that again. Alright, once again, I'm sheltered. I'm a survivor. Yeah, it's gonna be very tough for this character to get started, I realize. Because I can potentially be surrounded. But if I can actually, if I actually get a second to pick up a stone before I'm faced with some crazy monsters, then maybe I can survive. Alright, so we established I'm a truth teller. With a strong sense that's trigger happy and has animal discord and is I could hate fruits or vegetables, but I think that's no. Junk food and lactose intolerant, a lightweight who is a savant. And is a, was it something sleeper? Heavy sleeper, there it is. All right. But on the good side, he has like a strong, what was it? He's a pack mule who has a light step. And high adrenaline, although that didn't actually work out for me. So maybe I will say not high adrenaline. Good memory and a fast learner. And what else? Forgetting what else. Your morale is improved by fashionable clothing. I forgot about that one. No. Tempting, but no. Night vision, that's right. I love my night vision. Gotta have me some night vision. Being a light eater would be nice, but I don't think it's necessary. A fast reader. I'm gonna pass on that one. Disease resistance could be good. I guess just because I don't have anything else. Well, no. I'm just gonna save that for an extra point. You don't need to spend all your points on traits. Okay, so. 14 strength, 10 dex, 10 intelligence, and like 11 perception. Could make it 12 perception. No, yeah, I'm going to make it 11 intelligence, so 14, 10, 11, 11. So my character will have a lot of potential if he can just survive. All right. I could call him Chuck Stone 2, but no, he's Chuck Stone. I'm Chuck Stone. Maybe I should start in the Elmo shelter. Yeah, I'm gonna start in the Elmo shelter. Although the Elmo shelter is way out there in the wilderness. It has the advantage of having some starting supplies. Oh, hello there. This is a little bit different from what I'm used to. There's some shallow water, though. So yeah, there's water, and there's rubble. I see the setup of the Elmo shelter is slightly different. There's a wood stove, which is pretty cool, because you have... No, I didn't mean to destroy it! I didn't mean to destroy it. That was a wood stove. That was useful. That was really useful, and I scrapped it. I didn't mean to hit S. And it's funny how the wood stove just took out and got taken out in one shot. Okay, well, that was a screw-up. I mean, I meant to do that. I, Chuck Stone, meant to do that. Obviously, by the way, I said, no! Okay, well. That'll be fine. Oh, yes. Pick up a 2x4 to help you destroy. Takes you a very long time to wield your 2x4. And although I prefer to chuck stones, I will settle for chucking nails and 2x4s at things. It's good training for stones. Alright, so what do we got in here? Oh, is there, was it just, were the crates? Just Necco wafers. I don't want to eat those. I have a flashlight, that'll be useful. A hammer, that's useful for breaking things apart. A brick kiln, screwdriver, or another brick kiln, two brick kilns. Want to make some bricks. Some books, some bookcases. Might as well disassemble some of those. I'll wield the hammer instead. And drop the 2x4. Yeah, that smash is much better. A canvas sack full of commercial fertilizer. Don't know what the difference between commercial fertilizer and non-commercial fertilizer is, but I'm sure there are some. I'm sure the quality, I guess, is. The quality is probably higher or more preservatives or something. I don't know. There's something different. Alright, so we have some ammo for Remington, some ammo, a bunch of ammo, but no guns! Great! Or no, wait, is this a gun? Nope, yeah, that's ammo. Alright. Well, I don't... Good! Metal stones! I can throw these metal stones at people. If you did throw these, would they actually do damage? I'll try it. I'm gonna throw... Look, metal, little metal stones, perfect. These are perfect for throwing. That's all it is for Chuck Stone. Alright, well, we got a nice little shelter here. If only I had a shovel. I could drink from the toilet, but I don't wanna, because I've got a better source of water. Alright, so let's see what's outside. Alright, a fox and a bullfrog. Neither of those are grenadier zombies waiting to kill me. So... I can throw bullets 11 squares, I can throw nails 11 squares, I can throw 2x4s 8 squares. Alright, let's start throwing. Oh, a zombie dog, that's a bit of a concern. Alright, at least it's a distance away. Alright, I'm near. What am I near? I can see a lot because I have good perception. I am near a river, I am near a mansion, and a FEMA camp. Which is where my previous character died in a FEMA camp. Not in that particular one. I mean, it could be, but we see three. Three FEMA camps. FEMA was all over this place, apparently. Alright, let's start by training on this fox. Well, throwing these nails? Yep, throwing these nails is improving my focus. The fox is avoiding the projectiles. The fox is probably fleeing now. The fox is fleeing. Come back here, fox. Come back here, fox. I need to train on you. Let me throw my nails at you. Let me throw these little metal stones at you. Alright, the zombie dog is still to the north. I don't want to tango with the zombie dog yet. Can I get away from it? Good. The zombie dog's over there. I'm just going to go away, and hopefully the zombie dog will go away, and we won't fight each other. I would like more training before I fight with a zombie dog. I would like to throw stones. Ah, rock! That. Now that is a projectile. Fitting for Chuck Stone. A befitting. Fitting projectile. Ah, a dragonfly down there. What's that? What is this? A sinkhole? That's a bad thing. That's a very bad thing that you do not want to step into. Okay, yeesh. That's a trap. It's a heck of a trap. And Actually, if you fall into a sinkhole without, like, some sort of climbing tool or digging tool, I don't know how you would get out. Potentially. A sinkhole seems like a potentially fatal trap. I don't want to... That scares me. It's good that I have good perception. So, let's try to find some sort of swamp monster to throw things at. And picking cattails. Okay. Why would you want to do that? What? Oh, I do not manage to do it, or what? Oh, no, I did. Oh, another... I just spotted another... Oh, no space. No space for cattail rhizome. Oh, I'm carrying water. I don't want to carry this water with me. Alright, I'm going to go put away this water. Chuck Stone doesn't have space for water. Put that down. And I'll put down these 2x4s. I'll take one 2x4 with me. I'll leave the other one. Pick cattails? Yes. I get some cattail rhizome. What can I use this for? Oh, it's actually nutritious? A stout branching rhizome from a cattail plant. Its crisp, white flesh is very starchy and fibrous. You really ought to cook it before you attempt to eat it. It's not very enjoyable. I don't know how to cook it, though. But that's good. Let's pick these. Let's pick the crap out of these. Let's pick the cattails. And gather up some food. This will be a long-term food solution. Alright, well, this is rather convenient. And hopefully, eventually, I'll train my throwing skill. Or can I train my throwing skill by just throwing things around here? Huh. My focus just went down. Yeah, I think I can train my throwing skill just by, like, throwing at a wall. Alright, that works. I guess. Seems kind of awkward. Chuck Stone throws nails at a wall to learn how to throw. He practiced day and night, throwing at a wall to become the ultimate throwing savant. Yeah, my throwing skill's already 2. Wow. Chuck Stone already knows how to throw very well, but he's going to get even better. Chuck Stone is more like Chuck Nail at this point. But eventually I'll graduate to being a full Chuck Stone. So is my throwing skill still going up? It's still going up. Yep, it's nearly... This is gonna be boring, but it'll work. Oh, and I should pick up this... Actually, this scrap metal will be useful as a throwing... No, it's not that great for throwing. Well, I feel bad about breaking up that wood stove, but I guess I didn't really need it. Still. Feel kind of bad. So if I break this apart, I get some scrap metal. Some steel. And a pipe. What Chuck Stone's going to want to start crafting is bayonets. But other throwing items would be nice too. Chuck Stone's going to break apart this desk. Get some more nails. Chuck Stone likes nails. They're like little metal stones. Chuck Stone also likes bullets. Also like little metal stones. They're fun to throw. But they're not as fun as actual stones. Nothing's as good as a rock. Wait, can I just throw at the floor? No, you cannot throw at the floor. I actually have to throw a little bit to the side. So, yes, I'll just do this all night for days on days on end until I run out of food. Why am I sad? Because I'm wet. Chuck Stone doesn't like being wet. Right, this character's gonna have more of a problem being wet because my previous character was thick-skinned, which also means water resistance, but eventually I'll get equipment that'll keep the water. Even the stone might be worn down by water if he's dripped on it enough. Chuck Stone's afraid that if enough droplets of water drop on Chuck Stone, that Chuck Stone will wear away slowly, like those stones in caves. Chuck Stone's seen it happen before. Sure, it might take millions of years, but Chuck Stone's not gonna take any chances. Well, it doesn't really happen to living creatures because we, well, also it takes a really, really long time. But living creatures also, they heal. They come back. Nope. Chuckstone doesn't like it. Chuckstone's not taking any chances. Chuckstone's not messing with water. That freaks Chuckstone out. Alright, well, my focus is nearly gone, but my throwing skill is already level 3. That's pretty amazing. I mean, it's not nearly as amazing as my previous character, but I'm going to be gaining skill a lot faster, and it's not going to rust. It's not going to rust for nothing. Well, it's going to rust, but it's going to rust very slowly, so I anticipate that I'm going to get a very, very high throwing skill. Alright, Chuckstone needs the rest, I think. Because Chuckstone's losing focus. What else can Chuckstone do down here? Chuckstone can make a rock and a sock or a 2x sword by cutting 2 2x4s. It would be better than nothing. Or a nail board. Which one has less weight? The 2x sword has less weight. So I think I could throw a 2x sword a lot further than a nail board. A nail board has a selling price. You could sell a nail board. Or pointy sticks. Pointy sticks throw quite well. But a 2x sword is actually weighs less. It has 12-1. That's 4-8. Let's try making a 2x sword. Chuckstone can't see to craft. Chuckstone's gonna need to get to the surface. Alright, Chuckstone's gonna make a 2x sword. A bullfrog leaps from the water. 2x sword. Wield. Drop the hammer. It's time for Chuckstone to drop the hammer. Oh, let's put these inside. Put down these cattail rhizomes. I wish I still had my bionic stomach. I don't mind not having my other bionic bits, but I am going to miss having a bionic intestinal system. That's the main thing I'm really going to miss from my previous character. Alright, so the 2x sword I can throw. Chuckstone can throw a 2x sword. Oops, not the hammer. I can throw the hammer really far. A 21. And the hammer is up to 22. I can throw really far already. So, yes. I'm gonna be like an artillery platform. Chuckstone is gonna be able to throw really far. Really, really far. Alright, so like I said, I can throw the 2x sword 21 spaces. Now, if I made, let's say, no, don't pick up the Necco wafers. Chuckstone doesn't like Necco wafers. Chuckstone likes Neccos, but not Necco wafers. Okay, so if I take this stuff and I made a pointy stick, how far can I throw a pointy stick? 15, whereas I can throw a... Yeah, the 2x sword is definitely the better choice. Let's make some more 2x swords. They will be adequate throwing weapons for now. They'll be a starter throwing weapon. Not as good as stones, but they'll have to do. Craft another 2x sword. Alright, crafted 2 2x swords. I've got a little bit of fabrication skill, but it's going to take a long time. But once I learn something, I won't forget it. Or at least not very easily. It'll be very difficult for Chuckstone to forget something once he learns it. Because he is a savant and has a good memory. And an intelligent savant with a good memory, so even though it'll take me a long time to learn other things, once I do, I will be able to preserve that knowledge much more easily. Mostly, though, I'm all about the throwing skill. I'm interested to see how good I can make my throwing skill. I'm already up to level 4, so I'm doing a really good job of getting my throwing skill back, which was the crowning achievement of my previous character. Sure, the claws were pretty good, but it's all about the throwing. And if I can find my bayonets from my previous character, I will be really powerful once again. Chuck Stone's gonna be the best thrower in the world. Chuck Stone's gonna be the best thrower in the universe. Chuck Stone's gonna throw a rock at the sun and take it out, because that's how much range Chuck Stone will be able to... how much range that Chuck Stone will have. It's funny. Throwing skill helps you throw further. I mean, it's true to a certain extent, but at a certain point, your muscles are just gonna be a limiter. It's like, at a certain point, it's not form. Form can only take you so far. You're just gonna need stronger arms. Chuck Stone intends to get bionic pitching arm. A bionic chucking device. He's gonna become a robotic thrower. A robot pitcher. Oh, did I throw all my nails again? Alright, Chuck Stone's tired. Chuck Stone's going to bed. Chuck Stone's closing the door. Oh, Chuck Stone can make more pointy sticks? Because of the other stuff that's nearby, but Chuck Stone can't see, so Chuck Stone's going to sleep. Chuck Stone is having trouble sleeping? What do you mean? Chuck Stone is an easy sleeper. Chuck Stone's hungry and thirsty. That's normal. Alright, Chuck Stone's gotten sleep. Chuck Stone's feeling better. Chuck Stone's gonna keep throwing nails now. And eventually, Chuck Stone will get some food. Chuck Stone would like something that improves his morale, but Chuck Stone's happy enough. Chuck Stone can get by. Right now, I feel more like Chuck Nail, though. But once I get through chucking these small metallic stones, I can, yes, advance to greater things. I kind of said that. Alright, Chuck Stone sat there and threw nails for an exceedingly long period of time. Note my stamina being very low. Hopefully, the more skilled you get, the less stamina it takes for you to throw stones or various things. Doesn't seem like it. It seems like the range doesn't increase every single notch. I guess the range is increasing by a percentage. So that, yeah, I don't get an extra range with my nails every skill point. But yeah, other things like my rocks, I seem to be throwing a bit further. Why did I throw there? The 2x sword? I didn't mean to throw you, my dear 2x sword. Let me wield my 2x sword. One of them. I can't take all that. Although the splintered wood. I could take splintered wood. Yeah, let's make a bunch of skewers. That's more little things than I can throw. That don't weigh much. Throw, 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 throw. I don't know why I'm, throwing all the way over there when I can just throw right next to myself. Chuck Stone sits around in bed chucking nails off the side of the bed. If I can chuck enough nails off the side of the bed accurately enough, I will become the ultimate thrower. So just remember that, everyone. Just practice throwing little things off the side of your bed, get some sleep, eat well, and eventually you'll become the greatest thrower in the universe. And then you'll be able to defend yourself. Then you'll be able to go into combat and fight people that have actual guns. And he'll just be able to throw stones at them and win. You'll be able to throw stones so far, you'll be able to throw stones at people in other continents. If you just practice every single day, and you are a savant, trust me, it works. It's kind of surprising this is working. Alright, I'm going to eat some cattail bits, because it's something to eat. And I'll drink this water. Even though I don't like the cattail bits, it's the one thing I have that is perishable. It's the one perishable food I have. And so I should be eating it before, or consuming it before other things. All right, it is daylight. Yeah, I have that indicator now, but as soon as you get a watch, you permanently get the time indicator instead of that daylight indicator. That's interesting. It's interesting that you don't lose it once you lose your watch. That's, I find, kind of surprising. Alright, so I'm full. It's the middle of the day. I'm going to see if I can't get more cattail bits. I'm feeling a little bit more confident in my abilities. I've got my 2x swords. Let's see what's out there. I got the bullfrog. I'm going to put safe mode on. Definitely. Or no, safe mode off. No, safe mode on. I want safe mode on. And let's harvest some more cattails. I'm going to be careful, because I don't want to fall in a sinkhole, and we found several sinkholes in this area, and I've had one of my other characters die from a sinkhole. I didn't understand how the game worked when I played the game, the first version of the game, and I think I suddenly fell down in a place, and it's like, how did that happen? Was that just a weird bug? I can't get out of it. No, that was a trap. That was a trap called a sinkhole, and they expected you to be able to get out of it using some sort of digging tool and or rope, I believe. But my character did not have either of those. And this character does not have either of those either. So I've got to be real careful. Got to be real careful. But I've got awesome perception. I'm light-footed, so there's a chance that if I step on a sinkhole, I might avoid it anyways. And that's it, really. That's keeping me alive. But and it's still just early game, so... Whoa! You've spotted a sinkhole real close. Jesus criminy. Yeah, you gotta be real careful in the swamp. Maybe I shouldn't be wandering in the swamp. Oh, my word. I should get a digging tool. Is there a digging tool? If I have a digging tool, I'm probably safe, right? I think. Do we have a digging tool in here? A trowel. Chuck Stone feels safer if he has a trowel. Alright, so if I have a trowel, then I can, like, dig. I can dig a pit. I can till soil. I can dig a pit, but can I, like, dig up... Like, digging and mining. Dig mine upstairs. That requires a lot. Fill pit. That requires one tool of a digging of two or more. Well, maybe the trowel shouldn't make me feel any safer, because all I can do is dig a pit with it. I can't dig myself out of a pit. Okay then, well, I'm just gonna slowly skirt this area. And I know if I step on an underbrush, there can't be traps in an underbrush. That fox is looking very delicious. That fox is ignoring me. Gray fox should learn not... Or not gray fox, but fox should learn not to ignore... Oh, the fox is no longer ignoring me, is it? They're not getting away from Chuck Stone. Although, first I'm going to chuck a sword at you. Grazing... It reflects off the fox's thick hide? Really? Wow. Foxes are a lot tougher than I expected. I can't beat that fox. Well, that's surprising. Okay, easy now. A heavy stick. Don't make me throw a heavy stick at you. It's not within range. I'm gonna hit you with bullets. Bang! Ba-bang! And I'll say bang every time. Or nails. Let's fire the nails. Ooh, I didn't do damage with all those other things, but I'm doing damage with nails. That's kind of surprising. Alright, then prepare to be nailed. Nope. Okay, fine. So if I throw a nail on this square where the hole is, will it fall down the hole? Nope. Okay, so much for using nails to find the locations of holes. If I fall down one of those holes, I think I'm done for. Although, I don't think holes can appear in water spots. Wait, move. If you walk really carefully, I should theoretically... No, I don't want to drink water with my hands. I should theoretically discover the holes before I fall into them. Theoretically. Wait, it made me wield my nails? Oh no, that's right, because I'm not wielding my hammer. Or no, my 2x sword. I was wielding a... Stop wielding nail, store it, or drop, or... Yeah. Alright, that's better. Chuck Stone was wondering what the deal was with Chuck Stone's inventory, but that's because Chuck Stone was not wielding his 2x sword. Okay, slowly. Pick cattails. Thank you very much. Slowly move through the swamp. Pick cattails. Oh, no space. I'm sorry. Alright, well, let's get out of here. No, Chuck Stone does not feel like learning how to swim. So Chuck Stone will go over here. Alright. Chuck Stone's finally out of the swamp. Chuck Stone was worried about dying in the swamp. Chuck Stone is willing to eat acorns if it helps Chuck Stone survive. These sinews aren't weighing me down any. We're not taking any volume. Let's drop this extra food here that Chuck Stone risked his life for. I forgot that Chuck Stone was carrying a heavy stick. Well, Chuck Stone will make something out of that stick eventually. Alright then. Should Chuck Stone do any more adventuring in the outdoors? No, Chuck Stone should continue. He should continue training. Chuck Stone realized that Chuck Stone has not received enough training. Chuck Stone let that fox get away. Chuck Stone is not nearly good enough at chucking stones. If Chuck Stone was better, then Chuck Stone would be eating fox for dinner. But instead he let Bray Fox get away. Gray Fox. Actually, I don't think... The image for that fox was not gray. I don't care. I'm calling it Gray Fox. I think he was a member... I think that was a foxhound. Alright, I see. I see what you're doing there. Throwing nails all day. At least I'm getting more efficient in my nail throwing. In fact... Probably should just change. You really should just reassign that to T. TT throw. Alright, my focus is getting so low that it's just taking forever, so. Time for Chuck Stone to sleep. That's better. Seems kind of silly that you can train your throwing this way, but in a sense it makes sense. I mean, it's realistic as well, but it makes training a lot easier. I think if you're throwing on a living target, though, you might get more experience. I'm not sure, though. But I would hope if you're throwing at a real target, you get more experience than this. Hard to tell, though. You hear a thud. Times 49, times 50, times 51. Throwing skill increased to 6. I can now throw nails the same distance I used to. But I probably can throw other things further. The path to becoming a throwing master is long and in many ways boring. Chuck Stone would be a lot better at throwing. If Chuck Stone had better entertainment, then Chuck Stone would be much better at throwing by now. If Chuck Stone had better morale. It's too bad Chuck Stone isn't an optimist. Or Chuck Stone would be better by now, yes. That's the thing. Having high morale does help your learning rates. But I'm a savant, and that works. Alright, this is starting to take a really long time, though. Could make makeshift crowbars, but they're not really good to throw. Oh, I don't know how to make the bayonets. I must have learned to make that somewhere with my previous character, but I can make the makeshift knife if I only can get some spikes. And I can make spikes out of... Oh, that's right, the chunks of steel. Or scrap metal. I thought it was just... Oh, actually, maybe it was... I think that's a version change, because before I think it was just the scrap metal. That's cool. Now it's steel or scrap metal. Perfect. Let's make some makeshift knives. And I'll take the thread, and I'll get some rags, and then we'll have these pointy metal rocks that I can throw at my opponents. That's the way to describe them. That's okay. Look at this rock. It's metal and pointy. It's amazing. Now all I have to do is give that pointy metal rock a handle, and it'll be even better. Alright. Things are looking good. Give me that metal. Yeah, I'll drop the 2x sword. I don't need these 2x swords anymore. The hammer. Once again, that did 9 bashing. Whereas a spike does 2 bash. And 6 stab. So, a hammer is still really nice to have around. But it does take more volume, too. So actually, maybe I will drop the hammer for now. And these 2x swords, so I can pick up this scrap metal. And let's make more spikes. The storage space is a big issue. Scrap metal, scrap metal, scrap metal. Sometimes you have to make your own pointy rocks. When life doesn't give you rocks, you have to make pointy rocks out of metal. I can't see the craft. Oh. Throw. 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 Alright, I'm gonna throw a little bit, then go to bed. Actually, let's move these blankets. I would like to put the blankets at the corner. Okay, yes, I'm wearing a down-filled blanket. Alright, there we go. Now, with both the blankets in the corner, I'll be able to sleep more easily, right? Shut that door. I'm a heavy sleeper, so I don't want to get my brains nibbled out. Middle of the night. Okay, that's better. Do a little bit more morning training. Yes, this is getting a bit boring, and it's also not giving me... It's giving me surprisingly limited returns, so... Yes, I think I think I need to graduate to throwing at real live targets. And also just make the game more fun and more interesting, so. Let's munch on cattail bits. Let me put down... I have a bottle on me, right? Or no, I drank it off the ground. Okay, then. Oh, it's still nighttime. It's still nighttime. I don't want to go out at night. I don't like the idea of going out at night. Or maybe I do. I'm pretty silent. But, I can't see very far, which means I won't be able to throw very far. Range is definitely to my advantage. When you're a throwing character, oh yes, no. I'm not going out at night. No, I'm not having that. Not having any of that. I will sleep through the night. And since I have good focus, I will drain my focus a bit. Good enough. Sleep. Drain focus. Down to about 80. Good enough. Sleep. 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 Okay, focus is nearly full. Can't have full focus. That's not good. Or, well, it's fine, but that's wasted potential that you could be utilizing to become the master of all throwing. And that's no good. No one wants to have wasted potential. Alright, it's morning. Pick up my vast quantity of nails. And I'm halfway to my next throwing level. Eat a bit of cattail bits. Wait, what was that? Oh, ground 1S. Ground and ground 1S. I'm like, what's that other ground thing? My boxer shorts will not hold water. Did you know that? Oh, I am holding a plastic bottle. I don't want to hold the plastic bottle. I just want to drink from the plastic bottle. Alright. Alright, it's morning. It's time to do a little bit of morning crafting, and then I will go out in the world and potentially do some hunting as well. Oh, it's still not morning yet? Yo, that makes some noise. Well, I'll do a little bit more training. And then I'll rest here. And now do we have light? No? Now? There we go. Okay. I was getting a bit antsy. Spike. That's all the spikes I can make. Okay, then I'm going to need to find materials to make these into knives. I could rip up some of my bedding, but I don't want to do that. I like my down-filled blankets. And, well, my bed might be bigger than I need it to be, but I'm just gonna keep it like that. Right, munch on a little bit of cattail, and off I go with my 2 scrap metal, 3 spikes, 2 rocks. I should be taking one of those 2x swords with me. Take a 2x sword and the hammer. Wield the 2x sword. Take the other 2x sword. Alright, now I'm ready for anything. I'm not ready for anything, but I'm ready for whatever I encounter. There's a zombie dog up north. I don't want to go in the swamp anymore. The swamp freaks me out. What's that? Just a little fly or something? It's a dragonfly. Just a normal dragonfly. I was thinking of it as going to be like a giant dragonfly. Sorry, dragonfly, but you are now a target for Chuck Stone. You are now a training target. Which means I should be throwing my training projectiles at you. It reflects off the dragonfly's incredible carapace. That's no normal dragonfly. That's Metal Gear. This is a dragonfly. My throwing skills increased to 7. Yeah, I think this is giving me more experience than the other thing. Because, yeah, look at that. 7 with 12%. 7, 14%. Yeah, throwing at a live target is much better than throwing at a wall. But throwing at a wall is a form of training. So, yeah. Let's keep throwing at this dragonfly. Let's keep throwing nails at the dragonfly so I don't accidentally kill it. I was foolish to throw the sword at it at first. I apologize, my training target. See how much throwing skill I can earn out of this. I'm almost up to 8. Pretty soon I will be matching my previous character's throwing skill. Which was, what was that, like 11? I think I died with 11 throwing skill, which is pretty amazing. Alright, let's throw the skewers. It's a giant pile of throwing detritus. I'll skewer you. Wait, did I get it? No, it got away, or I ran out of skewers. Okay. I'm gonna pick my stuff back up. Stay right there, my target. Let's, yeah, continue throwing nails. Although I'm running out of focus now. I've nearly got my skill up to 8. So far, life has not been very exciting for Chuck Stone, but I'm excited about the sheer potential of this character, or the potential of Chuck Stone. Mr. Dragonfly, I would like you to go towards my shelter, in fact, so I am tempted to herd you, since you flee from me. No? I thought you were fleeing from me. I want you to go towards my shelter. Could you go towards my... Did I kill it? No! Dragonfly, no, I'm sorry. Come back to life. Come back. I need you. I'm sorry. What kind of person picks on small animals? You must be deranged. Who does that? What's this say? That's dirt. It doesn't say anything. Zombie drug? Truth or fiction? A blogger suggests that recent riots are a chemical attack by China. They are jealous of our cybernetic superiority. They teamed up with Haiti to put hoodoo drugs, you mean voodoo? Voodoo drugs in the water, making people zombies. Okay, hoodoo drugs. Hoodoo drugs. Of course it's hoodoo drugs. What else could it be but hoodoo drugs? I knew it. I knew it all along. It was those hoodoo, that hoodoo drug nonsense. I want more splinters. Cut up all you can. I want a big, big pile of skewers. Cut up all you can. Big, big pile of skewers. So are these skewers actually weighing me down yet? Nope. But the nails have one volume. Okay. I'm gonna set this thread down. Don't need that yet. And we got a pair of wrenches here. They're not bad throwing devices. My volume's pretty high. I could read some of this stuff. I'm tempted to read the 101 crafts. I think I'll do that. No, I don't drop. No, well, drop the hammer. Drop the hammer first before you drop a rock. I can't drop a rock. That's ridiculous. 101 crafts for beginners. Let's take that up to the reading area. Alright. So, yeah, that... Alright, let me... This contains 25 crafting recipes. It's... Affects your morale by 1, requires 5 intelligence, and can bring your crafting or fabrication skill to 3. It's pretty cool. So I can learn a bunch of things. I can make a shovel. That could potentially... Making a shovel could potentially save me from that hole. So I can make a lobotomizer? I can make a lobotomizer. What the hell is a lobotomizer? an adjustable stock, a folding stock, a bipod, the Food Co. Kitchen Buddy. Does it have to be a Food Co. Kitchen Buddy? Yes, it has to be a Food Co. Kitchen Buddy. You can't craft just a Kitchen Buddy? No. All Kitchen Buddies are Food Co., even if you make it yourself. Electric hair trimmer and head torch. A chapter of this book... I thought I was reading a crafting recipe at first. A chapter of this book takes 16 minutes to read. That's a weird crafting recipe. Alright. Let's read. Yes. I am studying. Feeling a bit cold. And despite the fact that I'm a savant, I can read... Actually, I think the savant doesn't affect my reading capability. It says I can read quite well. I can read so much faster than my old character, because I'm way more intelligent, and I'm not a slow reader, so... My fabrication level is 1. Let's continue to read. Also, this won't hurt my savant ability, because my throwing skill's already really high, so... My throwing skill is locked in as my skill that my savant is affecting. I am a throwing savant, and that's not going to change anytime soon. All right, I'm gonna set that book down. I'm very hungry and very thirsty. I'm out of cattail food. Ate some acorns. These acorns are terrible. Drink some water. Refill my water bottle. I'm glad there wasn't a zombie grenadier sitting right outside my shelter this time. like last game. That was nice, at least. I got a nice sleep. Alright, I can wake up now. I'm very hungry, and I'm thirsty. I can eat some of these canned foods, but I'm going to save them. I'm going to save my canned foods until I need them. For now, I'll just drink up more. Is it really bad to drink? Is it really worse to drink water with your hands? I don't know. It's just a wacky theory I was playing with, but I don't know if it's actually better or worse. I do not like going out at night. I am a thrower, and throwing is only good if you're doing it at a distance. Well, that's not entirely true, but it's best if done from a distance. You get the most. You get the most out of throwing if you can take full advantage of the incredible range offered by your abilities. So for now, I'm just going to throw nails at the wall until I get tired of doing that, and then I'll go to sleep again. Throw, throw, throw. Chuck Stone's gonna be the ultimate thrower. Chuck Stone's gonna be the best thrower in the world. They said Chuck Stone was a fool for throwing, just focusing on throwing things. Chuck Stone's gonna show them all. Chuck Stone loves throwing things. Chuck Stone was kind of good at basketball, but Chuck Stone never wanted to dribble. As soon as you pass Chuck Stone the ball, Chuck Stone would throw it at somebody. And he would hit them hard. Somehow that's a penalty. Chuck Stone doesn't understand that. Chuck Stone doesn't understand how throwing... Why isn't basketball a game? Now dodgeball. Now that's a game that Chuck Stone enjoyed a bit more. What was Chuck Stone's favorite sport? Dodgeball. And only when he was throwing. Can't quite seem to get comfortable. Is it morning yet? Okay, that's morning. Alright, I'm very hungry. Chuck Stone is very hungry. Oh no. I got food poisoning. That's not good. I was about to go out adventuring. At least my thirst is slaked. Maybe Chuck Stone should wait around until the food poisoning goes away. How long will that take, I wonder? Usually didn't take too long. Oops, I threw my 2x sword. Chuckstone doesn't want to throw his 2x sword. Alright. Get a little bit of sleep. Bit more sleep. Until my condition goes away. That's better. Although I'm back to being thirsty again. Okay, and this time I'm just going to leave well enough alone. I'll drink when I get back. But for now, and I will take this pointy stick with me, it will be good for chucking. Of course, I had another 2x sword, didn't I? I'll take that with me. Sorry, pointy stick. 2x sword. And the hammer. Alright, Chuckstone is ready to throw at life anything that life is ready to throw at. Chuckstone is ready to throw more at life than life is ready to throw at Chuckstone. Oh, the bullfrog's actually close by. Is that the only target in range? Okay, so I can throw at the bulldog. What should I throw at the bulldog? Bulldog, bullfrog. I guess the only option I have is... what, the scrap metal goes farthest? The scrap metal goes furthest. Or the spike. Spike! You miss. Spike. You miss. Spike. It grazes off the thick hide of the bullfrog. The American bullfrog. It's natural in its natural habitat. Tap. Tat. Tat. It feeds on insects, mice, lizards, and any other living thing it can stuff down its gullet. The American bullfrog. Not known for its amazingly thick hide that can stop spikes, but apparently today it is tougher than you would expect. Ah, good hit. You did 1 point of damage. A hammer. Smack. I would not think of a hammer reflecting off of a bullfrog's... oh boy, the dog is coming, isn't it? The zombie dog is coming this way. It is actually coming this way. I've got to be ready for that. And I've thrown most of my ammunition at the bullfrog, so... okay, the zombie dog's at 26. It will be within range of my 2x sword in a few turns. I've got some rocks. Same deal. Let's see if I can go get back my one of my sticks. Or not my sticks, my spikes. Alright, the zombie dog is 20. Alright. Time to start firing. Zombie dog. Slam, 2 damage. Good hit. Doesn't seem like that good of a hit. 6 damage. It's moderately injured now. 3 damage. Rocked him good. 2 damage. 2 damage. Alright, running out of projectiles now. Pocket knife. 5 damage. Alright, now we gotta back away. I could throw nails at it, but I don't like my odds throwing nails at it. Run. Full on run. Close the door. And hopefully when I open the door again, either A, the zombie dog will not be there, or B, at least, at the very least, I will be loaded up with plenty more rocks and rock-like things that I can throw at the dog. Let's get these wrenches. Screwdriver? I guess that throws... in fact, actually, the screwdriver will probably throw remarkably well. It just doesn't have the greatest attack power. So let's get these screwdrivers. Aluminum tongs. A heavy-duty flashlight. There's a lot of flashlights there. The hacksaw, which has some metal sawing quality. Alright, yeah, I'm just gonna screwdriver him a bunch. Anyone out there? Oh, there he is. There he is. Okay. I didn't expect him to be so close. Pointy stick. 11 damage. Crowbar. Slam. Okay. Whew. He's getting a little bit worried about that scenario. Thank you for bringing back the pocket knife. Butcher, butcher, butcher. I could eat a tainted bone, but I think I would rather not. Well, and let's... I'm going to leave these throwing items out here. And they'll be like... things on the ground that I can throw, that I can pick up easily to throw. I do want extra throwing items near my lair. Actually, I probably shouldn't be carrying around this extra ammo, because it's actually weighing, it actually has volume. Whereas these skewers do not yet. Okay, let's take the crowbar. The crowbar's got a lot of volume. Well, no, I want to take these things. And let's see if I can go out there and pick up my other things. my scrap metal. Maybe I should be manufacturing more spikes. Well, but I need food. I need food badly. Easy now, you're getting into swamp territory. Pick willow tree? Sure. What did I get from that? Willow bark. Used in the production of aspirin. Well, that's great. I'll just munch on bark for a while. That's delicious, right? Bullfrog, frog leaping about, having a good time. Okay. I feel very anxious when I'm in the forest like this, or in the swamp like this, for obvious reasons. I'm just gonna wait 3 turns every time before I move. Pick cattails? Yes. I'm surviving off of cattails. This is, a very grim subsistence. Grave business. Recent reports show a large spike in thefts, large spike in thefts from and assaults on human homes in the last few weeks, described as highly strange but not especially dangerous. Homeland Security is looking at connections now. I see. Lots of thefts from and assaults on funeral homes. So that's an interesting thing. It makes it sound like that was the person who caused the zombie outbreak was doing some prep work, gathering resources. That sounds like gathering resources to me, right? A giant web spider. I'm going to avoid that. Oh wait, can't I? Can I not pick? Oh, I was pressing the wrong pickup button, I guess. No. Oh no, it's too heavy. Okay. Well then, in that case, I'm going to set the crowbar here. I'll come back for the crowbar later, but I want this food now. Food is of greater importance than crowbar. Okay. That spot did look a little bit funny. Alright, I'm gonna munch on some of these to lighten the load. Wow, I was very hungry. Okay, I'm gonna need to get a lot more then. I bashed it! I didn't mean to bash it! Aw. Hey there, Mr. It's Mr. Dragonfly. Come here to train me some. Hello, Mr. Dragonfly. Training time with Mr. Dragonfly. Splash. No enemies nearby, so... No, Mr. Dragonfly, I'm sorry. You taught me well. Your training is complete, Grasshopper. I, Mr. Dragonfly, will disappear now. Somehow, an insect calling you Grasshopper as a student, it actually makes more sense, somehow. That Grasshopper thing never made sense as far as teaching is concerned, but... Any holes? Okay, freaky. Super freaky. Slowly working my way through the swamp. That is a dandelion. That is a bluebell. Pick my 2x swords back up. Wield instead? Yes. Alright, I have returned. Alright, where's my shelter? Okay. I will return. I've exited the wasteland, I should say. I will leave one of my 2x swords right out here. And I'll place this flesh inside. Or these fresh, not fresh, flesh, these fresh things. I feel like drinking from a container is just better. I don't know, I can't explain it. But I feel like it is. Alright, so my character is very unhappy about his diet, but I'm alive. Chuck Stone's gonna have to improve his diet if Chuck Stone wants to get much learning done. Alright, I think Chuck Stone is gonna do more adventuring. I was thinking of taking a break, but no, Chuck Stone is not ready to stop yet. Chuck Stone would like better food, damn it. And Chuck Stone is also a bit afraid of walking in the swamp much more. Chuck Stone is not particularly crazy about going through that area either. Let's see, Chuck Stone might want to make a fishing pole. How tough would it be for him to do that? Also, I could make stuff for knitting, but... Or I could make nail boards for traps as well. Can I make one? It would be in tools. Basic fishing rod. Yes, you can, of course. Heavy stick. Six long strings. The six long strings is a really tall order. That's right. Okay. Chuck Stone's gonna have to be careful on these long trips. Chuck Stone sees a coyote. That coyote isn't that far away. Chuck Stone can spike that coyote. Slam! Slam! The coyote is dead. All right. Chuck Stone has successfully hunted his first prey. I don't want to pick it up. Butcher, butcher, butcher. Chuck Stone has successfully butchered his first prey. Chuck Stone's going to leave the bones. Take the meat. Perfectly can fit the meat. And do I have... I have two books. Perfect. I was worried I wouldn't have enough fire. Start a fire quickly. And cook, cook, cook. I'm glad I carry a bunch of skewers. It's very convenient. Cook, cook, cook. Cook, cook, cook. Good enough. What's this here? One nail. What? No space for the nail? That's unexpected. Ah, delicious fresh meat. Alright, I'll light this one on fire as well. Make one more fire to cook. Because usually I have enough light sources. Hey, it's Mr. Oh, I'm too good now. I'm too accurate. Oh, I should be throwing skewers. I should be throwing the skewers, because they won't kill my dragonfly sensei. I am sorry, dragonfly sensei. I am sorry to have failed you, dragonfly sensei. Forgive me, dragonfly sensei. My character is happy now. A weasel and a bullfrog. Any of them close enough? No. Well, let's do a little bit of exploring and see what we can find. Oh, what's this? Is that... That's the weasel. Okay, hello, Mr. Weasel. I'm going to throw skewers at you and generally annoy you. Oh, you're fleeing now? Okay, well, I can't have you fleeing away. I was hoping you'd just ignore me if I started doing that, but instead you're going to have to get... not spikes, not yet. The pointy stick. And then the 2x sword. These 2x swords aren't really as good as I was hoping they would be. Yeah, spikes are way better. Spike. Spike. Dang it, weasel. That weasel is tougher than I expected. Heavily injured. Damn you, weasel. Get back here with my stuff. You've embedded things of mine in your hide, and I'm gonna get them back from you if it's the last thing I do. 3 damage. The weasel is dead, hooray. The future of Chuck Stone is assured. Okay, so the weasel walked along this area. So hopefully that means there's no holes. There's a hole there, though. I'm gonna go a bit slow, because, yeah, I'm in sinkhole territory. There's another one. Holy shit. Gotta be real careful. And I mean real careful. Alright, I'm gonna butcher. Ooh, look at all those cattails. A giant carp? Blinky? Giant carp! Hostile! This thing seems like a carp. Only swollen and very angry. Death is the gift of the carp god. Wow. That's an odd statement. And Blinky, a strange three-eyed fish. Well, there's some fish up there if I wanted to go fishing. Okay, I don't think there's a hole here. I'll pick the cattails. Oh, no space? No space. Then I will have to drop one pointy stick. Or no, the pointy stick I actually think is better than the 2x sword here. 2x sword. Although it doesn't seem like it's... The two bashing just does not seem to be as good as piercing. Although I'm wielding a spike, I want to wield the 2x sword. Can I wield the 2x sword? Yeah, that works. And then store the spike in inventory, and then give me the cattail bit. There's a bunch more cattail bits around. I have never seen a hole in a lake spot or in a tree spot. Yeah, I don't think the holes can appear in the water or on trees. However, I don't want to chance it. A pike dives in the water. I do not want to dive in the water. I do not trust the water. I think even a small bit of water could have a giant carp. And that giant carp could eat me. I could be awarded death by the carp god. And I don't want to be awarded death by the carp god. No. No, I think I'm fine on that, quite frankly, by now. Alright, I will drop this piece of metal into the shallow water for a bit of extra food. And same with this pointy stick, as much as I like it, for some extra food. Yes, thank you. Hop on the trees. Pick the cattails. Is it too much to... Wait, no. Okay, good. No holes there. Are you sure? Okay. Pick those cattails. Oh, you're asking me to drop again. Why, is there more than one? No, it's just because of the sheer amount I have. Alright, fine, I'll wield it instead. Careful now. Careful now. Alright. Pick up this rock and off I go. There's one more there, but I don't have space for it, so... Alright, I'm coming back with a nice supply of food. Hopefully I can't find, it seems like sinkholes are just a product of, mostly... of swamps. But... it's hard to be certain. Alright, so I just got a bunch more food. I am stocked up on food for now. My character is thirsty. Let's drink a little bit. No, I don't want to drink with my hands. Alright. The future of Chuckstone is rather secure. Now Chuckstone wants to spend the rest of his daylight hours producing more spikes. That's what Chuckstone wants to do. So give me that... these chunks of metal. And we'll get production started. Drop that. I'll drop that rock too, just for now. Steady now, it's okay. Easy now, it's okay. I dropped a rock, yes, but I'll get it back. Alright, and I'm gonna take these shelves and convert them into pointy metal rocks that I call spikes. Or spikes that I call pointy metal rocks, I should say. It's the other way around. Oops. Wait, where's my spike? Can't make any more spikes? Do I not have enough to make a spike, or what? I thought a spike was in here. In other, like, tools or something. Or is it a tool, or... Getting the category it's in. There it is. It's a material spike. Oh, I don't have a hammering thing. I must have lost my last hammering thing. Okay. Hang on, I'll be right back. Or no, I know where a hammering device is. Hang on. Excuse me. Oh, that's a screwdriver and two wrenches. Where was that hammer? I seem to have lost my hammers. Well, where is an item with some hammering quality? Did I throw them away? I threw them around. I know that. Oh, well, I should have a stone. That's hammering quality. A stone is all the... This teaches me a lesson not to drop a stone. Chuck Stone never drops a stone. That's all the hammering I need. Well, hopefully the hammering quality doesn't affect the production time as long as I've got the requirement. Because it seems like a hammer would definitely make things faster. How long does it take to make a spike? Not that long, anyways. Alright, so I've made some spikes. Lovely. Let's keep this up. Alright, so I'll leave the spikes on the floor. Alrighty, next load. I guess I might as well stock things up a bit and then get the production going. All right, let's get this fabrication going. Spike. Ah, my fabrication skill's up to level 2 now. Or yeah, that's right, because I read that crafting book. So it's been up to level 2 for a while now. But it's cool. It's also telling me... Or is it telling me... I guess I can still get fabrication skill from doing this. Or actually, I'm not sure. But before it was complaining to me saying, you won't get skill from doing this, you know. Whereas right now it's not doing that, but I guess this is not complaining, that's all. But it's not complaining, but that doesn't mean that I am getting skill from it, it's just not complaining, is my point. Just in case I don't break this, I'm going to move it before I break the shelf. Alright, there goes the shelf. More spikes. Make more spikes. Because spikes are incredible. And bayonets are even better. So how many spikes do I have in total? I'm up to 8 spikes now. I'll leave those there. Oh, and I have 5 spikes there. Okay, so I'm doing pretty good. I would like a full inventory of spikes. That would be nice. I'm glad all the food I found was edible for my character. Or all the food in the... All my long-term food, my canned food, is edible. So I've got that to rely on. A distaff and spindle, a pair of specialized wooden rods to spin fibers and... Or, yes, use to spin fibers into thread and yarn. Interesting, but not what I want to make, but very interesting. I was not aware of the name... I was not aware of this device, the distaff. I've heard of a spindle before, but the distaff... is a thing that I would have not been like, what is this object? A distaff? Or Can you tell us what a distaff is? No, I cannot. Can you tell me what a spindle is? That's used for spinning. That's used for spinning yarn. I can tell you that. Or spinning wool. Wool into yarn. Because I've used a spindle. I've seen a spindle in real life. And I've played with a spindle in real life. But I've also used a spindle in various video games like Ultima Online. And it's also the classic thing that, you know, what's her face? Pricked her finger on, like, Sleeping Beauty. Isn't that the Sleeping Beauty? Well, that's like a spinning wheel. Is a spinning wheel, like, the same as a spindle? Kind of. Not exactly. Or it's, like, parts. It's a part of it. It's part of it. Okay. Hey, it's Mr. It's the trainer. Mr. Dragonfly. The throwing skill trainer. Well, hello again, Mr. Dragonfly. Thank you for training me again. Hello, Grasshopper. Prepare for the ultimate throwing training. Soon you will be a throwing training master. Just try to follow my movements and hit me as accurately as you can. Thank you, Master Dragonfly. Your training has proved most valuable. I will continue to be your student and study under you as best I possibly can. Yes, Chuck Stone has a mental problem where he thinks that dragonflies are alive. He imagines that dragonflies can talk and are teaching him how to throw more properly. That's just a he has a tendency to anthropomorphize dragonflies, for they have taught him how to throw more than any other creature. Thank you once again, Mr. Dragonfly. I will see you again. You have disappeared for now. I didn't know skewers could do damage, actually, so aw. But you once again have taught me well. Thank you, Mr. Dragonfly. Your techniques are appreciated. I'm almost up to 10 throwings, or 9 throwing skill. Easy now. Giant web spider. Oh, 24 distance away. I could potentially hit it with something. Like a spike. But I don't want to chuck my spikes out there. I don't want to waste my... I don't want to throw my spikes into the swamp, because I don't know when I'll be getting them back. Oh, it's 2 giant web spiders, you say? Oh, I see. There's a giant web there. Alright. I'll pick that. And I'm going to eat it right now. Or no, maybe I'm not going to eat it right now. I'm going to eat. I forgot that I've been carrying this cooked meat around. Why can't I pick it up? Is it too heavy? Oh, they have 2 volume. Okay. reality finally dawns on you, my friend. Yes, they're heavier than you think. Alright, well, I'll just eat that, despite the fact that it does not make me very happy. And, I've been running all over the place. Stop that! Stop running all over the place. You're liable to get ambushed while you're exhausted. And that would be bad. Very, 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 very bad. Very. How bad? Very. That one nail is enough to make my pile worse. Alright, let's explore to the north. I do have safe mode on. Good, good. A car, a vehicle of some sorts. It's busted up. Is it drivable? No, it is not. Not by a long shot. I see a lot of stuff going on over there. Oh, whoops, wrong button. I thought I was doing the observe mode. So we're seeing a beaver corpse, blood splatter, another beaver corpse. Oh, and the giant carp. The giant carp. The giant carp has been killing things. I have to be very careful. The giant carp is angry at me right now. The giant carp is trying to kill me. I am kind of afraid that the giant carp might just run up on land and kill me. I'm gonna nail you, giant carp. Guess I'll get a little bit closer. Huh. I guess it's safe to do this. I'm gonna be paying attention, though. This makes me rather antsy. I'm going to nail you, giant carp. The giant carp is just another one of my... Now I see you have passed the dragonfly school of throwing. Now you will learn giant carp skill. The giant carp. You will learn the giant carp school of nail throwing. Okay, careful now. I don't even want to get... Now I will learn the way of the bullfrog. What's that? Well, that I see a ton of Fs. That is a ton of Fs and a plus. What are all those Fs? A bowfin, a pike, a whitefish, a small... Wow, that's a lot of fish. That's a lot of fish. That's just a lot of fish just hanging out at the edge of the water, just being fish. Okay. Well, if I want to do some fishing, I know where to go. I'm fine for food right now, you guys. I really am. But now let's learn the way of the bullfrog. Those bullfrogs can really leap. Alright, I'm gonna leave you alone for now. I'm afraid to even get close enough to butcher that corpse, because if I butcher that corpse, that means that if the giant carp was here, he could attack you. And I'm thinking that that giant carp, judging by the description, since they call it like a death god, I'm just going to treat it like that and just not even get too close to the edge of the water. It's not worth risking my life. I saw the giant carp earlier, and the giant carp can hide under the water. He can pop up at any moment. You'd think he could just hide in the deep water, but I don't know. I don't know if he can pop up in the deep or the shallow or not. I have too many questions, not enough answers, fear of the unknown. I'm just going to go hide. And I think that's good. I've got 9 throwing skill now. Thank you very much for watching this episode of Cataclysm Dark Days Ahead. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And I will see you next time, fellow survivors. Good night.